in truth, which we know the truth is what? Psalms 119, 142. That righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and thy law is the truth. So you're not going to get around it, not follow the Most High's laws. Y'all better understand. Going back to Isaiah 14 and 1. Isaiah 14 and 1. For the Most High will have mercy on Jacob and will yet choose Israel and set them in their own land. Right? So, that's why, you know, a lot of people have wanted people to follow them somewhere. Look, the Most High said, look, go to Isaiah 60. In verse 21. Isaiah 60 and verse 21. Thy people, the Most High's people, the 12 tribes of Israel, also shall be all righteous. We're going to be all righteous. They shall inherit the land forever, it's saying, right? So what we're reading about in Isaiah 14 and 1. They shall inherit the land forever. The branch of my planting. The Most High is going to do this. Remember, ain't no man going to save us. Y'all follow man if you want to. He said, the branch of my planting, the work of my hands, that I may be glorified. He's going to do this. So when he do this, we can glorify the Most High. Period. Don't fall into the traps, y'all. Don't fall into the traps. Because they dare to make you fall. So Isaiah 14, we're going to get through it. Isaiah 14 and 2. And the people shall take them and bring them to their place. And you know what they said? Don't forget what they said. What they're going to be saying, that's why I love the Bible, because it talks to us. Those that have ears, they hear. Remember what they said? In Zechariah 8:23, thus said the Most High Power of Hosts, in those days it shall come to pass that 10 men shall take hold out of all nations of the nations. Out of all languages of the nations, even shall take hold of the skirt of him that is a Jew. And Israelite saying, we will go with you, for we have heard that the Most High is with you. Right? So, because they're gonna be afraid. That's why I go to 2 Ezra 13. They're gonna know this without a shadow of a doubt. This future prophecy. All these nations, the army, the navy, the marines, the air forces of all the nations going to get together to fight on Mashiach Yavashah. That's why they got the space station up in the sky. And they all together when it come down to that, to maintain their powers and authority on this earth. So this is a result of them coming together to fight on Mashiach Yavashah. They're going to be scared, but yet they does fight. So getting right to the point of 2 Ezra 13 and 9. That's why they're going to be cleaving to us and say, we know the Most High is with you, because he's going to show for his chosen. One third of the 12 tribes of Israel, because two thirds going to be done away with. He's going to kill them. Of our people, the 12 tribes of Israel. That's why it behooves you to work to be one of the one third. 2 Ezra 13 and 9. And lo, as he saw the violence of the multitude that came, the army, the navy, the marines, the air forces of all the nations joined together, stopped fighting each other to fight Hamashiach Yavashai. He neither lifted up his hand, nor held sword, nor any instrument of war, but only I saw that he sent out of his mouth as it had been a blast of fire, and out of his lips a flaming breath, and out of his tongue he cast out sparks and tempests. And they were all mixed together, the blast of fire, the flaming breath, and the great tempest. This is fire to the utmost. And fell with violence upon the multitude, which was prepared to fight. The army, the navy, the marines, the air forces of all these nations prepared to fight. And what is he going to do? And burned them up. Hear that? He burned them up. Future prophecy. Every one. So that upon a sudden, a innumerable multitude, nothing was to be perceived but only dust and smell of smoke. When I saw this, I was afraid. Future prophecy. So now, oh, that's apocrypha. It's not real. It's not canon, as they would like to say. So let's go to Revelation 19:11. Let's see. Since you see what he said he's going to do to all these nations that come up against him, to fight him, Revelation 19:11. And I saw heaven open, and behold, a white horse, pure righteous power. And he that sat upon him was called faithful and true. And in righteousness he does judge and make war. Right? His eyes were as a flame of fire. And on his head were many crowns. He had powers and authority that the Most High had given him. And he had a name written that no man knew but he himself. He had a name that no man knows but he himself. And he was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood. And his name is called the Word of the Most High. So we have a vesture dipped in blood. And his name is called the Word of the Most High. And the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses. So the armies that he's talking about is that's going to follow him in white horses. That's righteous power. Armies that follow him are in Revelations 9:16. The army that's following him, Ashakabashai, is in Revelation 9:16. And the number of the army of the horsemen were 200,000. And I heard the number of them. So he's coming with 200 million angels. Listen. Revelation 19:14. And the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses, clothed in fine linen, white and clean. So they got clothes on. 200 million angels following him. And when you look at it, that's why I love the word, because it gives us understanding of all things. Look. How's he coming? Hold that. Isaiah 31:5. As birds flying. You know how birds fly? How birds fly? They fly in a V formation. You get one up in the front, and they come like a V. One is in the front, and they come like a V formation. That's how Mashiach Yahushua is coming. As birds flying, so will the Most High through Mashiach Yahushua of hosts of powers defend Jerusalem. Defend the Israelites. Defending also, he will deliver it. He's going to save us. Deliver means save. He's going to save us. And passing over, he will preserve it. You see? He will preserve us. So now, going back to Revelation 19. Verse 14 again, and the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses, clothed in fine linen, white and clean. So they're coming in a V formation. Listen, verse 15, and out of his mouth, we just read in 2 Ezra, the 13th chapter, 9 and 10, 11. Out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword. We know that sharp sword is fire. That with it he should smite the nations. Hear that? Let you know. That great multitude that's coming against him is nations. He's going to kill the nations. And he shall rule them with a rod of iron. That rod of iron is the laws of the Most High. And he treadeth the winepress of the fierceness and wrath of the Almighty of Almighty power. Now, I have the Zondervan Compact Bible Dictionary. And this is by Zondervan. When you look up Edom, to show you that the elite know. That's why you see they took out where the worms never die and the fires never quenched. But look up Edom in the Zondervan Compact Bible Dictionary. It says Edom. It says Edom figures prominently in the prophetic scriptures as the scene of great future judgments. See notably Isaiah 34 and 5 and 6 and Isaiah 63 1 down. As you can see, she is the only neighbor of the Israelites who was not given any promise of mercy from the Most High. You hear that? The only neighbor of the Israelites who was not given any promise of mercy from the Most High. And look at scriptures. Isaiah 34, 5 and 6. Let's go there. Isaiah 34, 5 and 6. So this is nothing that we wrote. Zondervan wrote it. See, what keeps up from us, you put in the book. So we have many books that we can look at that coincides with what the word says. That's the only thing I want to see, something that coincides with the word. Isaiah 40, 34, 5 and 6. See what they gave us to look at. For my sword shall be bathed in heaven. Heaven is a condition on this earth too, right here. Behold, it shall come down upon Idumea. Uh-oh. And upon the people of my curse. So we got to look at this word Idumea. Who is Idumea? Idumea. Let's look that up. Idumea. Bear with me. Idumea. It says pertaining to Edom. Greek and Roman name for Edom. See Edom. We just read Edom. So it's talking about the Edomites, the indigenous so-called Caucasian people. It says, for my sword shall be bathed in heaven. Behold, it shall come down upon Idumea, the Edomites. All right. So let's look at another case scenario. Idumea. This is when we get ready to come up on this day that we, as the Israelites, say we're going to remember in recognition of getting the victory over our enemies when our forefathers, Judas Maccabees and his brothers and the men that were with him, regained our temple back, right? So we're going to 1 Maccabees 5 and 1. We're looking at who this Idumea is, because that's what they say. It's going to come down upon Idumea. So 1 Maccabees 5 and 1. Now, when the nations round about heard that the altar was built and the sanctuary renewed as before, talking about we was able to get our, you know, altar back and our, you know, be able to come together to worship the Most High as before, it displeased them very much. It displeased these nations that we're able to call on the Most High and be righteous, where the Most High will defend us and be for us. It displeased these nations very much. Wherefore, they thought to destroy the generation of Jacob that was among them. We scattered among these nations. So they thought to destroy us, all of us that was among them, living among them. And thereupon they began to slay and destroy the people. They began to slay us and destroy us, the Israelites that were scattered among these nations. Then Judas fought against the children of Esau in Idumea. See? I'll read you again. Then Judas, it was Judas Maccabees, fought against the children of Esau in Idumea. And we just read Idumea, pertaining to Edom. Edom, Rome. We know the Romans are so-called Italian Caucasians. Then Judas fought against the children of Esau in Idumea. You see? At Arabatim, because they besieged Israel. and he gave them a great overthrow and abated their courage and took their spoils, took everything they had. See? So, that's what we're looking at. Going back to these scriptures that they gave. Isaiah 34:5. In the Zondervan Compact Bible Dictionary. For my soul shall be bathed in heaven. Heaven is a condition on this earth. Behold, it shall come down upon Idumea, the Edomites, and upon the people of my curse to judgment. That curse is leprosy. They're clean lepers. Without any pigment and melanin, it's talking about. They gave verse 6. The sword of the Most High is filled with blood. It is made fat with fatness, and with the blood of lambs and goats, with the fat of the kidneys of rams. For the Most High hath a sacrifice in Bozra. Bozra was the capital city of Edom. And a great slaughter in the land of Idumea. Esau of Idumea, see? They coincide. This is what they're giving pertaining to the definition of Edom. So they went to Isaiah the 63rd chapter. Remember, that's for the way of the Most High. They have not known it. So they're going to know exactly how to break this Bible down, but it's for the children of Israel to know. Isaiah 63:1. Who is this that cometh from Edom? With dyed garments from Bozrah. Remember, you have a sacrifice in Bozrah, Esau's capital city. This that is glorious in his apparel, traveling in the greatness of his strength. I that speak in righteousness, mighty to save. This is Mashiach Yahushai. He's speaking in righteousness. Remember, you're going to judge him by righteousness, but with a rod of iron, which is righteousness, which is the laws of the Most High. We read that in Revelation 19 chapter. Mighty to save somebody. The children of Israel. One third, mind you. This is what it says. Let's continue to read on. Wherefore art thou red in thine apparel? Because remember, going back to Revelation's 19th chapter, it says, verse 13, and he was clothed with a vesture or a garment dipped in blood. And his name is called the Word of the Most High. Right? In the beginning was the Word was with the Most High, the Word was the Mashiach Yahushai. Okay? So I got to finish that. The Word was Mashiach in John 1, because we never did finish that part, because we were dealing with Mashiach Yahushai created everything through the power of the Most High. So let's go there. We're going to continue. St. John, first chapter, verse 3. All things were made by him, and without him, Mashiach Yahushai, was not anything made that was made. Okay? So, there we go. That's the third time I showed you. That's him. The Spirit of the Most High that's moving upon the waters, that's created, started to create everything. Most High created all things by Mashiach Yahushai, who is the Spirit of the Most High. In Genesis, the first chapter, the first verse, and the second verse. That's why in verse 26, it says, let us go down and make man in our image, in our likeness. The Most High and the Mashiach Yahushai. So now, we're going to Isaiah. They gave us Isaiah 63rd chapter. So Isaiah 63:2. It says, wherefore art thou red in thine apparel, and thy garments like him that treadeth in the wine fat, like somebody stomping on grapes. See, I have trodden the wine press alone, and other people there was none with me. He's going to do this himself. He said, I'm going to be all alone doing this. For I will tread them in mine anger, and trample them in my fury. And their blood shall be sprinkled upon my garments, and I will stain all my raiment. Going back to Revelations 19:13. Remind you, they gave these scriptures, they gave this to look at. And once you looked at it, you keep on going, you see what it says. Revelation 19:13. And he was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood. And his name is called the Word of the Most High. And the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses, clothed in fine linen. They not no butt naked angels. They had clothes on, clothed in fine linen, white and clean. And out of his mouth go up a sharp sword, that with it he shall smite or kill the nations. And he shall rule them with a rod of iron. That's the laws of the Most High. And he treadeth the winepress of the fierceness and wrath of Almighty Most High. And he hath on his vesture and on his thigh a name written, King of Kings and Power of Powers. Okay? So now, going back to Isaiah 63rd chapter. Verse 3. I have trodden the winepress alone. Remember it says, hey. In verse 15 of Revelation 19, and he shall rule them with a rod of iron, and he treadeth the winepress of the fierceness of and wrath of Almighty Power. Right? So now here, like I tell you, there's no New Testament. They only have the law and the prophets. So here we are. It's telling us, Isaiah 63:3, I have trodden the winepress alone. And other people, there was none with me, for I will tread them in mine anger and trample them in my fury, and their blood shall be sprinkled upon my garments. Just like we read in Revelations 19:13. And I will stain all my raiment. You see how this goes together. For the day of vengeance is in mine heart. The day of vengeance is in his mind. And the year of my redeemed is come. The redeemer of the 12 tribes of Israel, one third, mind you, of the 12 tribes of Israel. He said, I looked, and there was none to help. So I looked, and nobody was there to help me. And I wondered that there was none to uphold. Therefore, mine own arm brought salvation unto me, and my fury, it upheld me. He said, I will tread down the people. So you know that it's not talking about no regular sacrifice of animals. He said, and I will tread down the people in mine anger and make them drunk in my fury. And I will bring down their strength. That's their army, navy, marines, and air forces of all these nations that got together, as we read about in the future prophecy, to fight on Mashiach Yahushua. It ain't gonna be nothing but dust and smell of smoke. That's the end result. That's why these nations are gonna be cleaving to us. They're gonna say, oh, no, we know the Most High is with us. That's why I'm showing you. Why it's gonna go down like this. And I will tread down the people in mine anger and make them drunk in my fury. And I will bring down their strength to the earth. We just read about it. Nothing but what? Dust and smell of what? Smoke. From that fire that he's going to bring forth. Isaiah 9 and 5. For every battle of the warrior is with confused noise. And garments rolled in blood, but this shall be with burning and fuel of fire. You hear that? It's gonna be with burning and fuel of fire. As it is written. Now let's go back to Isaiah 14. Now that we have an understanding of what's gonna go down. And you love the Most High more and more and more, knowing that it's going to go down and everything going to be okay in righteousness. Everybody should want to be in righteousness. So it's going to be a remnant of all nations. So everybody should want to be part of that remnant of the nations that's going to be fulfilling this. Isaiah 14:1. For the Most High will have mercy on Jacob and will yet choose Israel. And set them in their own land. The Most High gonna set us in our own land. He said, my planning, remember? Not no man. It's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of living power. You gonna take his place? That's a dangerous job. Many people that have done it, they gone. They gone. For the Most High will have mercy on Jacob and will yet choose Israel and set them in their own land. And the strangers, these other nations, a remnant of these other nations, shall be joined with them. And they shall cleave to the house of Jacob. We know why they're going to cleave to us. I just showed you. Prophecy of what's going to happen. And the people shall take them and bring them to their place. They're going to be glad to be with us. They're going to say, they're both sides with you. Because we're going to be here. Most I will. When I say, well, I'm talking about the 12 tribes of Israel, because we don't know if we're going to be there or not. Hopefully, most I will be there, but nobody knows. I'm not claiming it. You say, dare not make thyself one of the number. Say, the righteous scarcely going to be saved. It said, and the people shall take them and bring them to their place, and the house of Israel shall possess them in the land of the Most High for servants and handmaids, for men slaves and women slaves. We're going to be the new IRS, Israelites receiving services forever and ever and ever. And they shall take them captives, whose captives they were, and they shall rule over their oppressors. That's what's written. We're going to rule over our oppressors. So we have to be a nation. Even if they want to try and cancel us out, they can't cancel us out, because the Most High said they can do those certain things, take away day and night, then we won't be a nation. They can measure if the sun and the moon and the stars is not there anymore, then we won't be a nation. Can't do that. So now that they're gonna be in captivity, slavery, and bondage, and it's in the righteous kingdom though. We're not talking about the things that we went through. Though it's not gonna be easy. It's gonna be no easy task now. Listen, verse 3. And it shall come to pass in the day that the Most High shall give thee rest. Just when we're going to have that rest. From thy sorrow, and from thy fear, and from the hard bondage wherein thou was made to serve. That's when we have rest. When we have servants and handmaids. Let's go back to Jeremiah. We're in the 30th chapter. And we're going to start at verse 3. Jeremiah 30 and verse 3. For lo, the days come, said the Most High, that I will bring again the captivity of my people, Israel and Judah, the 12 tribes of Israel, said the Most High, and I will cause them to return to the land that I gave to their fathers, and they shall possess it. That's what we've been talking about. And these are the words that the Most High spake concerning Israel and concerning Judah. Israel is the northern tribes, and Judah represents the southern tribes, which represent the 12 tribes of Israel. One third, mind you. But thus said the Most High, we have heard a voice of trembling, of fear, and not of peace. Select you. We have heard a voice of trembling, of fear, and not of peace. Jacob's trouble. Jacob's trouble.
Is Jacob's trouble, it's lucky.
That's right.
Is Jacob's trouble on the fifth seal?
Oh yeah, we still in it. We ain't out of it yet. Because we haven't really fulfilled all the things that's written. You know what I mean? Things haven't occurred that has to occur. We in it. But everyone's not going to have to go through it. That's why it behooves anyone to hear my voice to try and their best to learn it, live it, and apply the Most High's law, Ten Commandments, and the law of the Spirit, of the fruits of the Spirit in their life. So we're looking at Jeremiah 30 and 4, and these are the words that the Most High spake concerning Israel and concerning Judah, the 12 tribes of Israel. For thus said the Most High, we have heard a voice of trembling, of fear, and not of peace. Ask ye now, and see whether a man does travail with child. Is a man having a baby? Is a man having contractions like a woman have contractions whenever she's getting ready to deliver a child? Wherefore do I see every man with his hands on his loins? And as a woman in travail, and all faces are turned into paleness, you know? And that's deep because that's why he told us in Revelation 18 and 4 to come out of her, my people. Come out of her, my people, that you receive not of her sins. And the plagues that the Most High is going to bring upon this place. But if you look at it, while you hear me saying, I got to do a lesson on this too, exclusively, the sheep and the goats. Faces are turned to paleness. Why? You hear me say, melanated, colored Edomites, or in that same mindset. Look, Isaiah 29 and 22. Faces are turned pale, right? It says, therefore, thus say the Most High, who redeemed Abraham concerning the house of Jacob, who live in the house of family of Jacob, who's the 12 tribes of Israel. Jacob, whose name was changed to Israel, he's our forefather to be created the 12 tribes of Israel, shall not now be ashamed. Jacob shall not now be ashamed. We as the Israelites shall not be ashamed. Neither shall his face now wax pale. You hear that? His face not going to wax pale. But what happened? In Jeremiah 30 and 6. Ask ye now and see whether a man does travail with child. Wherefore do I see every man with his hands on his loins? As a woman in travail, as a woman having contraction, having a baby, and all faces are turned into paleness. Your face, I mean, anything that you're going to be able to bring forth in this earth is through your face. Because out of your face, your mind, your words, then your actions. Paleness, you're going to turn to paleness, turn to him. And you're going, Most I got something for you. Isaiah 13 and 14. Isaiah 13 and 14. And it shall be as a chased roe. They're going to be like a chased deer. And as a sheep that no man taketh up. And if I don't want to be bothered with them in this time to come, they shall every man turn to his own people. Hear that? Every man going to turn to his own people. The Chinese going to turn to the Chinese. Japanese going to turn to the Japanese. Africans going to turn to Africans. Arabs going to turn to the Arabs. East Indians going to turn to East Indians. Edomites going to turn to the Edomites. Caucasian people going to turn to Caucasian, and they're going to turn to their own people and flee everyone into his own land. Hear that? We don't have a land to flee into. Judah. We scattered among all nations, four corners of the earth, and flee everyone into his own land. They're going back to their own land. Listen, everyone that is found shall be thrust through. Everyone in this time going to be thrust through. And everyone that is joined unto them shall fall by the sword. So you join unto them, you have that same mindset. You a goat, you think like a goat, think like them. Remember what it said, that's when salvation is coming to this earth for the Israelites. They're going to say, that's for the way of the Most High and the Mashiach of Shai, we have not known it. So you're not going to know it. That's why you call yourself a Gentile. You say you've been grafting in. You don't know who you've been grafting in among. You got to speak in tongues. Ain't nobody interpret nothing you're saying. And you got to be filled with the Holy Ghost. Don't even understand the definition of the Holy Ghost. It's written in the Bible. Show me the definition of the Holy Spirit. That's written in the Bible, the Spirit of the Most High. Most of them can't tell you unless they don't listen to, you know, some lessons that we have brought forth through the Spirit of the Most High. Other than that, they don't know. They just run around the church like a chicken with his head cut off, hollering and screaming and jumping and music going do-do-do-do-do-do-do. They jumping around like a chicken with his head cut off, thinking that's the Spirit of the Most High. That ain't the Spirit of the Most High. He said the Holy Spirit will bring all things back to remembrance. As you roll up with the Holy Spirit, you're supposed to go through this and precept. You can understand through the precepts. Go here, go there. It's like I say, precept upon precept, precept upon precept. Here a little and there a little. Precept upon precept, precept upon precept. Line upon line, here a little and there a little. That's how you get understanding. Like we're doing here. So it's telling you. You have that mindset, you say all faces done turn pale. Stop believing the way they want you to believe. Remember, Revelations, if you don't remember, you're going to know. Revelation 12, 9. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceived the whole world. You hear that? Deceived the whole world. But you're going to believe in them. When you don't even know. Psalms 58 and 3. Y'all trying to make something, y'all trying to act like the devil got power on his own. The devil got more power than the Most High, let you tell it. Psalms 58 and 3. The wicked are estranged from the womb. They go astray as soon as they be born. Doing what? Speaking lies. So the earth, tell you in Job 9:24, for the earth is just, the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covered the face. We just read in Revelation 19:11 that a Mashiach of Shai coming back to do what? Judge and make war, right? So it says, Job 9:24, the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? So here go the face. This is how he did it. He covered the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? He covered the faces of the judges thereof. He covered the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? Mashiach of Shai just said he's coming to judge and make war. So we know. I mean, this is what they did. This is what they did. So they lied to people until this day. So when you look at going to the Apocrypha, the earth is given to the hand of the wicked. He covered the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? And we need to talk about the entity Satan. We're talking about a man that's ruling the earth, and he came on this earth. And like I said in Psalms 58 and 3, the wicked, that's the wicked, are estranged from the womb. They go astray as soon as they be born, speaking lies. Speaking lies. So 1 Maccabees 3:48 says, and laid open the book of the law, wherein the heathen, these other nations, the Edomites, because that's what, let me get the Bible. Wherein the heathen has sought to paint the likeness of their images. Holy Bible. Open it up. First thing you see, the heathen sought to paint the likeness of their images. The heathen sought to paint the likeness of their images. What does this say here? It's falling apart. It says, Genesis 1 and 1. In the beginning, God created the heaven and earth. So you can't deny the fact that they're saying that this is God. This is the Most High right here. This is what they're saying. This is the Most High. This is the Most High right here. Can't deny that. So they opened up the Bible, were in the heat and sought to paint the likeness of their images. Not only that, look at this. And it's crazy because here we go. I got to keep putting it in your face so you see. This is in the Bible. That's supposed to be Jesus Christ when he's 12 years old. That's supposed to be Jesus Christ when he's 12 years old. Sitting with the doctors and lawyers and so forth. He's a blind hair there, right? Y'all got to explain to me, well, how'd he come a brunette right here? There he is right there again. Bam. Brunette. Pictures all in this Bible. See? So somebody done lied. And we read what it says, wicked are strange from the womb. They go astray as soon as they be born, speaking lies. Who's complaining about this? Who's saying this is wicked? Who really love Amashiach Elvashai? If you say you love him, why aren't you going against this, speaking out against this? Because you have to pay. That's why it says, 1 Maccabees 3:48, and laid open the book of the law, which is the Bible, wherein the heathen had sought to paint the likeness of their images. You see that? So let's go to Wisdom of Solomon. 14. Verse 9. For the unrighteous and his unrighteousness are both alike hateful unto the Most High. For that which is made shall be punished together with him that made it. That which is made, we sin, gonna be punished with him that made it, and those that accept it. Therefore, even upon the idols of the Gentiles shall there be a visitation. Hear that? The idols of the Gentiles shall there be a visitation. Because in the creation, excuse me, in the creature of the Most High, they are become an abomination and stumbling blocks to the souls of men. See, that's a stumbling block. You'd be surprised how many people believe that the so-called white man is the Most High. How many people believe that Amashiach Yavashai, the only begotten Son of the Most High, the anointed Savior, is the so-called white man. One of those pictures. They believe that's who he is. That's what it's saying, what it's saying. Long before they painted it. That was painted by Michelangelo in 1492. Until this day, because I still have it. Look at Trinity Broadcasting Network or any mega so-called pastor that have a mega church. They're smashing that. And they say they love him. You don't care about him. If you ain't going against that. How you care about somebody? They say this is you. I'm going to tell you something. You think about this. You worked hard all your life. You say, I'm going to leave something for my children. And maybe you have a great insurance policy that you pay on every month. So whenever you go, they got $1 million policy that they can have. And when you die, they say, oh, no, that's not yours. No, they give it to another nation.